New York, and on the new Hot 97 app. Ebro in the morning on Hot 97.
Yo, Taylor Swift, if you're in town, come up. We have this, we have a controversy in the country world. Lil Nas X.
I would love for her to weigh in on this.
I need you to weigh in, Taylor, on if this song... Where's Lil Nas X? Play it again. Old Town
Road.
It'll
only take 30 seconds.
Yeah, the song's 90 seconds long. That might have been why they yanked it off the list, off the chart on Billboard. It was like, this song is literally not an entire song.
This is where we're at. And this is... That's the hip-hop part of it. You want to know the most hip-hop part of it? The length.
Because songs now are legit 2 minutes long.
I know. When you see a song that's 4 minutes long, you're like, oh, this rapper's old.
It's not even...
They yanked this off the country chart. They said it doesn't represent sonically today's country.
I'll tell you what it is. It's fraudulent. I saw the video. He is, I'm, this kid is not riding horses on country roads.
Yeah, but stop the song. I have a question. Let's stop. Let's have a... If he's not riding horses and any of that, how many rappers on the rap chart, artists on the hip-hop chart, ain't living the lives that they're talking about in their songs? Mm-hmm. We should... Hip-hop should have started yanking things off of charts a long time ago for not being hip-hop enough. If they're, if charts are allowed to have some sort of board that determines what is and what isn't, because I didn't know that was a thing.
Yeah, I'm curious to know who that is who got to make the call to pull it off, or was it like labels calling and complaining?
Whoever it was. Because if that's what we're doing out here...
Then who gets to decide the hip-hop ones?
Because I'm calling and complaining.
But they don't care.
Over and over again. Because I wasn't calling... I mean, I might complain on the radio, but I'm not calling anybody being like, yo, this shouldn't be on the chart. This shouldn't be on the chart. We're yanking things off the chart because the artist categorized the song as country trap. Mm-hmm. That's how he categorized the song.
I would just like to say, even though I like this song, but I do not need the genre country trap. I just like to say that.
Different discussion.
But you're right. I don't understand. How would someone make that? I'm looking right now. Let's see what the hip-hop charts look like.
He's black and infiltrated. So they got to shut it down. You know what it is.
You think it's because he's black?
Yes.
And his name is Lil Nas X.
Yes. Doing country
play the tune for Lil Nas X, man.
Black boy out of here.
I love that you trolled the country charts, man. And I don't even like this song. This song is trash. Go get him, son.
Ebro, let me read you something.
What we got, Rosenberg? Because that's a country song. It's just got hip-hop elements.
See, now listen, at first I actually disagreed. To me, it's a hip-hop song with country elements.
Okay.
Not a country song with hip-hop elements.
Fine.
It reminds me of like Baby Bash or Nelly, stuff from that era.
Okay.
I actually kind of like it. It's pretty catchy.
It's catchy tune, for sure.
Guilty pleasure, for sure.
For sure, and it only lasts 90 seconds.
Fortunately,
so it's
short
not
guilt,
hurt
but
you.
Guilt's over quick.
There you go.
But here's where I start getting angry. If y'all are going to pull this off the country charts. The hip-hop charts. Number one song on the hip-hop charts on Billboard right now is Sunflower. Anyone know what that is?
Who?
I do.
You know the song Sunflower?
Ja Ja and Asaya sing it all the time.
Because it's from?
It's Spider-Man.
Exactly.
It's the number one song.
And who's it by, Shawnee?
This is the number one song in the hip-hop charts. That's right. This is from the Spider-Man movie. Turn it up.
Guess who it
all
is?
All they do is sing. Your man Glover.
Post Malone.
Oh, this Post Malone, right.
Post Malone and Swae Lee.
Yeah. It's a good song.
But hold on, let's hear if this should be on the hip hop charts.
They love it. Needless to say, I keep a check.
She was a bad bad, nevertheless. Calling it quick. Sounds like it should be on the pop chart.
This is a pop song. Pull it off.
Wait for the part.
Yo,
the part.
This should be pulled off the charts, bro.
That's not a hip hop.
Yeah, yank it off.
Tell him, Laura.
Yank it off.
You want to know what number two is on the hip hop charts?
What is it?
Wow. Post Malone, Wow. Thank you, DJ Cass.
You have the Wow song?
Yeah.
Play Post Malone, Wow.
The Wow song.
I ain't
going to
lie. I actually like this one.
I like the last one. It's not about liking or not liking.
Let's
see if it's rap.
Listen, let's be clear. That's not the discussion we're having about whether the songs are good or not.
They're all
we're
good.
Talking about if we're going to start yanking songs off of charts. She tied a little money, need a big boy. Pull up 20 inch blades like I'm Lil Troy. Now it's everybody flocking, need a decoy. Shorty mixing up the vodka with the liquor.
I'm okay with this one.
Yeah, me too.
Being on the chart. I don't love it, but I'm okay with it.
Oh, he said Fall Out Boy. Put him on the rock chart.
No, he already said Lil Troy, though.
Oh,
he already said Lil Troy.
Okay, all right.
All right, so listen. You know what the number three song? Well, I'll let this one pass. Guess what the number three song is?
Tell us.
Please Me, Cardi B and Bruno Mars.
R&B record.
A straight R&B record. I know she raps on it, but...
It's hip-hop?
On the hip-hop charts. Told this no! On the same chart in which the song behind this is the number four is Middle Child by J. Cole. Wow. A true rap song. So, like, why are they pulling the country one and the rap charts are completely infiltrated with...
Multiple genres.
No one cares about the hip-hop charts. No one's fighting for the hip-hop charts. Mm-hmm. Everyone's happy to have Post Malone.
Yo, get us an editor. Get us the editor of the Billboard hip-hop chart. I want to know who oversees the Billboard hip-hop chart. We're going to put a face to all of this. And I want to know who oversees the Billboard country chart. Let's put a face on this so the audience can know what's going on out here. Because I don't have a problem with them saying that Lil Nas X isn't country.
Me too, but I just want, that's fine. I'm good with it, but y'all need
but,
to pull some
But I do have a problem, but nice. I do have a problem. If the artist says, this is my interpretation of country, and I want to include it as country trap, and that's the category I want to create.
But would you feel the same way in reverse if someone who was absolutely not rap was like, I'm sorry, to me this is rap?
It's already happened.
But that's exactly what's happening right now. It already happened.
But I'd rather go the other way of not accepting.
Oh, so you want to start yanking stuff?
Yes.
Petty Rosenberg.
I'm here to yank instead.
You'd rather yank. Petty and draw lines.
Pause.
Yeah, pause. But I'm good. If y'all are going to take that off, you have every right to. But we wanted to go ahead and take this Sunflower record, the little kid song from Spider-Verse.
Put it in the pop
cute
category.
Cute song. Very cute. Put it on the pop charts. Right. That joint sounds like the Baby Shark song. Take it off.
Don't disrespect that Spider-Man song. That joint is fire. Have you seen Spider-Verse?
No, I know it's great. Bro. I know it's a great movie. I'm not dissing the movie.
But you don't even like animation like that.
No, I would enjoy it, though. I've heard it so good.
But he's not even dissing the song.
I'm not even dissing the song. Right. The song's good. I'm just saying it's a pop song, 100%. And Post Malone is, I get it, he's sort of a cross-genre artist, but that
doesn't
mean...
Lil Nas X is a cross-genre artist then. That's my point.
But I don't know if that, but to me, this Lil Nas X song...
Nah, let it all blend, bro. Let it blend.
It's not a country song, though.
Why not?
Because it's his version.
But like then you're ruining the argument for pulling off the...
Right, because I'm not for pulling. I think that's disrespectful.
You think you should just put everyone in any category?
If that's their interpretation of
music...
By the way,
let's kill the whole categories altogether then.
Let's do that then.
I'm fine with that. If we're going to go no
category. How do you think hip-hop got so popular? Hip-hop got so popular and the charts got so influential because the artists wanted to make sonically hip-hop records and interpret hip-hop differently. That's how the music got so mainstream as it is today.
Right.
That's helped the genre get bigger. If you want the genre to get smaller, then you yank things off.
That's a good point.
You see what I'm saying?
But there is a danger to anyone being able to say they're in any genre that they want. And be like,
but our genre is really important.
This starts getting into a deep philosophical
but that's what
issue
I'm saying.
About the way we see the world.
Because hip-hop, the reason hip-hop has stood the test of time is because the essence of the creation of the music incorporates so many different genres, it forever can evolve. We've sampled jazz, country, rock records,
but don't you, I've seen R&B. You make the same argument, though. I've seen you make the same argument that it's dangerous to have a song like the one we just played as
I'm
number
just
one
disagreeing
in the hip-hop
with
charts.
You, for the sake of the entertainment
Got it.
Of the
okay,
show.
Okay, because I know you've had a problem with stuff like that
for
before.
Sure, I have a problem, but we're already there in the hip-hop category. But now country, some country dudes on the Billboard side that literally never embrace.
I just want the rules
by the
to
way,
be down the
by
board.
The way, never, country never embraces the black country artists. True. Never, never.
Not-
I can name three albums right now that are, two. K. Michelle made a country album and a lady by the name of Priscilla Renee made country albums. They're black artists. The charts didn't embrace them at all.
I'm sure that's true. Didn't the charts embrace the Florida, the Tim McGraw Nelly song?
Yeah. Tim McGraw.
But that's because it was Tim McGraw.
And the Florida Georgia Line Nelly songs?
Florida Georgia Line.
But you're saying you come out as a black artist. What about Darius Rucker?
Wasn't he with the what you call it first, though?
Yeah, but not as a country. As a country artist,
but
he was
still a pop genre crossover accepted in that world first. Then he became that. And how long ago was that?
A long time ago.
You remember K. Michelle? We have an interview. If you go
she was
back,
like, they won't let me make country music.
Yes. That's, yeah.
Well, listen.
They straight up told her no.
And the real answer might be they just didn't want to deal with K. Michelle, but that's a different conversation.
Ebro.
I'm just saying, she knows the rules, she's difficult.
But the rules need to be the same down the board.
Discussion.
The rules need to be the same
down
the board.
But that's my point.
Yeah, if you're going, you don't have to yank anything, but if you're going to yank Lil Nas X out of the country chart, mm-hmm. then you need to yank the Post Malone, Sway Lee out of the hip-hop chart.
100%.
Producer Griff says there's somebody named Cowboy Troy that's been embraced.
Oh, Cowboy Troy, he had a record that hit
Cowboy
the chart.
Cowboy Troy. Yeah. Is he popping right now, though? Exactly. Right now, though.
And why didn't Nelly Country Grammar end up on the country charts?
Facts.
It had the word country in it.
Facts. These are all facts, what you guys are saying.
Ride With Me couldn't have been a country song. If you would have go, take a ride
that
with me.
That is a country song.
That is a country song. That is a country song.